Hello everyone, here's a short video update of the park as at around the 10th of May 2020. Sadly, I'm unable to bring you any new video clips as I'm under lockdown like most of us. However, here's a selection of lovely still photographs taken around the park during the past few weeks, and they were all taken by our own Marla. I hope you really enjoy these. Let's make a start with a couple of cracking shots of a bee on a bloom. It proved a very good idea to create a pop-up park book swap. Oh dear. The donated books were displayed on a couple of weekends. This was very popular with many books taken. Spacing the tables out and leaving them unattended worked well, and antibacterial wipes were available for anyone to use. The idea was a great way for encouraging visitors to the park, especially as the weather was so fine. Early in April, these tubs of soil with upright posts appeared in the park. What were they for? Well, they're bee posts. Untreated timber is essential, and the holes are made to encourage bees to make their homes. Taking close-up photographs of bees is far from easy. By the time your brain has told you to press the shutter, the bees' wings start a buzzing, and this is your resulting photographs. Much work has been done clearing hidden aspects of the park, behind this shed and fencing, for instance. John Perkins created this compost bin, and Marla and Lisa helped fill it with the compost. This very unsightly border by the lower Sainsbury's car park is in the process of being renovated. When finished, it's hoped to stop people using it as a shortcut. It will have flowers and plants and will be turned into a bug palace. Work has already started with the adding of a heavy rope barrier and some bunting for the holiday weekend. Further bunting has been placed around the park to brighten it up. As the work proceeds, we'll publish more pictures to show the different stages of the renovation.